In the past, I've hooked up various external hard drives to Raspberry Pis using the USB interface. When doing large transfers, this has always been quite slow. I believe this is due to the Pi ports being USB 2 ports. However, the Raspberry Pi 4 has USB 3.1, which promises much better speeds. Of course, there are more factors than just the bus speed involved in performance. So how much more performance can we get out of a Pi 4 external hard drive setup? Let's find out. For my quasi-scientific test, I'm going to use a Pi3 with USB 2, a Pi4 with USB 3.1, and just for comparison's sake, the USB 3.1 interface on my laptop. For all three devices, I'll use the same Mini Pro 1TB external USB 3.1 solid-state drive. A link to the specific drive is in the description if you're interested. In case you're an eat dessert first kind of person, or you're just interested in the numbers, let's look at the results first. The read cache test is really just checking how fast we can read from the computer's cache. It doesn't read from the disk at all. But the test was free, so hey. It does show that there is an improvement in the throughput from the Pi 3 to the Pi 4. My laptop wins big here, but it costs just a tad more than the Pi, so it needs to win something here. The read buffered test, that shows reads from the actual disk through the OS buffers. So look at that improvement, over 300 megabytes per second. That's awesome. That's what I'd hope to see. Moving on to the write tests. If we're writing lots of small files, the Pi 4 is improved and it's almost as good as my laptop. For the slightly bigger file writes, the Pi 4 performance has doubled. For the 50 meg file and the 1 gig file, the performance improvements between the Pi 3 and the Pi 4 are even greater. Well, I think the results are clear. If you're looking to have something like a media server or an NFS server using a Pi and you're wondering if the upgrade to Pi 4 is worth it, based on these results, I would say the answer is a resounding yes. For the rest of this video, I'm going to go through the procedure I ran on the Pi 3 just in case you want to test your own setup against these results. I started with a standard Raspbian install for the Pi and my SSD drive containing a single partition formatted as ext4. There are links in the description to videos and articles that show you how to do these two things if you need them. Once shelled into the Pi, we need to install some tools. Let's install INXI to dump out some system info for posterity's sake, and let's install hdparm to do the read tests. We'll use dd for the write tests, but that's already installed in base Raspbian. Let's dump out the hardware info for this Pi. And now let's run the read tests. The combination of capital T and lowercase t options cause hdparm to do both cached read tests and buffered read tests. The cache reads actually read from the Linux cache without hitting the drive, so this isn't really a disk read, but a test of the Linux cache access on the computer. So it can give us a clue if there are any improvements in the processor cache and memory throughput between the Pi 3 and the Pi 4. The buffered retest caused data to actually be read from the disk, stored in buffers, and then returned to the user through the buffer, so it's an indication of how fast the drive can continuously read sequential data. We'll run the test three times and take an average of the results. Now let's do some write tests. For these tests, we'll do actual writes to the file system using dd. First, let's mount the drive temporarily on /mnt. For the first test, we'll simulate writing 5001k files. In all cases, we'll use the desync output flag to force the system to use synchronous IO. This will give us a better sense of when the write actually finishes. For the next test, we'll write a medium-sized file, say a 1 meg. Next, let's write a slightly larger file, say 50 meg. Finally, we'll write a 1 gig file in two chunks. I'm breaking it into two chunks because the Pi doesn't have enough RAM to write it in one. Now that the testing is done, let's unmount the drive. All that's left to do is to repeat these tests on the other two devices. Here are the results again. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching. If you like this video and would like to see more, please consider subscribing to my channel.